Hello and welcome to Illustrator Training Day 4. So before we start Day 4, let us quickly recap Day 3. In Day 3, we learned about Adobe Illustrator preferences. We didn't cover all of those preferences because we thought covering few of them will be a good idea when we have learned some of the tools, rather than just learning it now without having any knowledge about the tools and how it works. So we will cover them later. Next, we learned about hand tool. So it is a good way to navigate your canvas. And then we learned about zoom tool, how we can zoom in and zoom out. The advantage of zoom tool above other method is you can zoom into particular area. You can just drag a rectangle around the area and it will automatically zoom in to that area. After learning that, we learned different ways of zooming and different ways of navigating. So when we recalled, we came to know that there are total four ways of navigating the canvas and there are total four ways for zooming in and zooming out the canvas. Now, there may be other ways and there may be more ways to navigate and zoom in I might have missed, but that is okay. The main point is, if you do anything in Illustrator, there can be several ways to do the same thing. Now, any approach is fine. It completely depends on your taste or your choices. Moving on, then we learned about screen modes, that Adobe Illustrator support three screen modes: normal, normal without maneuver, and full screen mode. Or it is like normal, semi, full screen, and full screen. Now, those modes can be switched back from toolbar, or you can switch through those modes using your F key on keyboard. Then we learned about views, how to create your custom views, how to switch to those views, and how to delete those views. Also, we saw that view only manages the information about zooming and navigation. Alright, so let's see what all we are going to learn in Day 4. In Day 4, first of all, we will cover guides and rulers, which we were supposed to cover in Day 3. But we couldn't because we were running out of time, we were short on time. So we will see it today. And then we will see about artboards. Now, what is this artboards? We have covered a little bit of it in day 2 video, day 1, I think. But today we are going to explore this option in detail. Then we'll see about artboard panel and what all options do we get with artboard panel. Then we'll see about artboard tool, how it works, and exporting your artboards. So if you want to export all of your artwork scattering around different artboards, then how can you do that? All right, so let's, without wasting any further time, now let's just quickly create a new file. File, click on new, and I have made some changes here. Let me get back to default settings. Untitled one, custom, and I hope you still remember and know all these settings, how it works. If you have forgotten or missed any of this, then you can go back to previous videos where I have covered this, and it will help you a lot. And I press OK here, so it will give me a new file. Now we will see about rulers and guides. So what we have learned so far is we can press Ctrl R on keyboard to bring up the rulers, and to create guides from these rulers we can click on any of the ruler, either the vertical one or the horizontal one, and drag from there anywhere on the canvas. So click on the ruler, drag and drop anywhere on the canvas. So by drop, I mean dropping the guide, and you have to release your mouse to make the guide over here. So it's as simple as that. You just click on the ruler and drag on around your canvas, and when you release your mouse, it will create a guide for you. Now there is another way to create guide, a more quicker way. So if you double click anywhere, let's say here around here near somewhere around 8, I'm double clicking. So I just double clicked over here and it created a ruler by itself. So when I double clicked on horizontal ruler, it created a vertical guide for me. And in the same way, if I double click anywhere on vertical ruler, it will create a horizontal guide for me. All right, so there is a, like I was saying, there are several ways to do same thing. Now we just saw that there are two ways to create a guide. So again, it depends on you, which way you prefer. There is no problem at all with any way. So now let's see some of the guide options we have. To see few of the guide options, go to View in menu bar. Then here we have Guides. Now we have few options like Hide Guides, Lock Guides and Clear Guides right now. So before learning this, let me show you some more ways you can interact with guides. Now let's say you have all your guides lined up in here, but you want to move this guide and bring it inside the artboard. To move any guide, you can just click on that guide and move your mouse and then release to reposition it. It is as simple as that. You can just click on any guide, horizontal or vertical, and then move your mouse around and then release to reposition it. Let me quickly change this color of, let me quickly change the guide's color so that it is more visible to you guys. Let us change this color to red. I think red will be visible properly. All right, so red is very clearly visible now. So yeah, where was I? To reposition a guide, you can just click and drag and release to reposition it. Now if you want to move multiple guides, so what you can do is you can just click and drag. So you can see there's a rectangle following my cursor. So now if I release this rectangle, or if I release this mouse over here, then whatever is included in this rectangle, here we have three vertical guides which are inside this rectangle. So all these three guides will got selected. Now you can just click on any of this selected guide and move all of them. And when I release my mouse, it got repositioned. Now to do this, make sure you have your selection tool selected. If you have any other tool selected, then this will not work. You will not be able to move guide at all. So make sure you have your selection tool selected for this one. The shortcut key to select the selection tool is V on your keyboard. So if you press V, it will select the selection tool. All right, so now just delete that shape which I just created and press delete. Oh, now I just did something. You might have noticed that I actually deleted a guide accidentally. Let us see how we can delete a guide. So to delete a guide, it's very simple. Like we moved the guide. So to delete a guide is very simple. All you have to do is go and select the guide you want to delete. Either you can click on the guide and release to select that guide, or you can drag your cursor or drag your mouse and select multiple guides. And when you release it, it will select all those guides fall under that rectangle. And when you press delete key, it will delete those guides. So now I am left with only two guides on my canvas. So now I can create some further guides. And here I have a margin kind of thing around my canvas. It is not very proper because I haven't measured anything. I just dragged it normally and made those guides. So it is not very precise, but still good for example. Now if you want to move all these guides together, you can do that also. Just zoom out a bit. drag your mouse. Now in under this rectangle, under the selection rectangle, all these guides comes in. So like you would have imagined, all of this will be selected, and now I can move this entire guide base because I selected all of them. Anyways, so press Ctrl 0 to fit artboard to the screen, and now we'll see how to log guides, because it might happen that once you fix all your guides and once you have all your guides lined up, so let's say if you are going to draw something, you accidentally clicked on this guide and then you moved it. So it might happen to you so many times. So it's a good option to log the guides before we start the work. So first lay out all your guides. Once you have all of them proper position, then you can just log guides and start working. So to undo the last action, press Ctrl Z on your keyboard to reposition that guide again. And to log all the guides, go to View, Guides and Log Guides. The shortcut key is also present for it, Alt, Control and Semicolon. So right now I'm just clicking over here, and now you can see if I go and select any of the guide, I cannot do that. It's not even selecting. See, when guide gets selected, it turns into blue color. So I'm not able to select any of my guide right now, and even if I click and drag on any of them, I'm not able to move it. So that means my guide is logged, and now I can do my work without even worrying about that I accidentally will move any guide or something. So again, to unlock them, go to guides, and either you can press Alt, Control, Semicolon on your keyboard, or just click over here to unlock these guides again. Now I'm able to move them again. Similarly, go to View, Guides and click on Hide Guides to hide them. To again show them, you can press Ctrl Semicolon on your keyboard to hide and show the guides. Again, it works as a toggle switch. Alright, so let's see what other options do we have here. The other option we have here is Clear Guide. So I can click on Clear Guide, and what it does is it removes all the guides on the canvas I have created. To bring them back, you can press Ctrl Z, but if you surely want to delete all your guides, it is a good option to clear the guides, or there is another way also, you can select all your guides and press delete. I think it is locked right now, so let's unlock them. Select all your guides, press delete. It works the same way, or you can go to View, Guides and Clear Guides. So like we saw two options for creating guides and two options for deleting guides. So let us quickly recall what all options do we have for creating guides. We can click and drag to create guides, or we can double click on the ruler to create guide. So these are the two options available for creating guides. Now again, there may be some more options which I haven't covered yet, or maybe I just don't know, because the software itself is like you keep exploring and you keep finding new things in the software. So let's see what all options do we have for deleting the guides. So either we can select all of them and press delete on our keyboard, or we can go to View, Guides and Clear Guides. The two ways for both creating and deleting the guides. Now so far all the options or all the guides we have seen are in a line form. So either it's a vertical line or it's a horizontal line. Now what if I want to arrange something inside a circle? So it's a good idea, let's explore it, how we can do it. To create a guide from an existing shape, all you can do is create a shape. Now how do we create a shape? We'll cover it in future chapters, but right now just let's say we have a circle over here. Let me quickly fill color in it, and अच्छा, इट हैज सम कलर ऑफ ऑरेंज. ऑलराइट, नॉट एग्जैक्टली ऑरेंज. सो वी हैव दिस सर्कल ओवर हियर. नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू मेक अ गाइड ऑफ दिस, अ सर्क्यूलर गाइड. सो वट आई कैन डू इज गो टू व्यू गाइड्स एंड देन आई हैव वन मोर ऑप्शन अनलॉक्ड हियर. प्रीवियसली इट वॉज एक्चुअली लॉक्ड, लाइक दिस रिलीज गाइड्स एंड क्लियर गाइड्स. नाउ आई हैव वन मोर ऑप्शन अनलॉक्ड विच सेज मेक गाइड्स, और कंट्रोल 5 इज द शॉर्टकट की फॉर इट. सो लेट्स क्लिक ऑन दिस वन एंड सी वट हैपन्स. सो क्लिक मेक गाइड्स एंड हियर वी गो. वी हैव अवर सर्क्यूलर गाइड नाउ. अगेन लाइक we used to move all the guides, in the same way we can just select and move this also. It will exactly work like a guide. You can reposition it and you can select and press delete on it. You can either go to view guide, log guide. So it is logged now. You don't have freedom to move it anymore. And if you want to unlock it again, you can go to view guide and unlock it. For hiding it, you can press control semicolon on your keyboard, so it got hidden, and again to unhide it. So this is how it works. If you want to create a guide from an existing shape, now you can take any shape you want. It's not just limited to circle. You can take either a star or a rectangle, or even it may be your custom defined shape. So it's all completely up to you. And up to the project requirement, actually, I should say. All right, so let us unlock this first and control alt semicolon and delete this. Before we move forward, let's see if I want to get my shape back from this circle itself. Now I have created a guide out of the circle and I have my purpose served, but now I want that circle back. Actually, let's say if that color or that shape is important to me, it's important for my design, I want to place it back. So what I can do is select that guide and go to view guides, and here you have a new button or new label unlocked which says release guides. So let's click on release guides and see what happens. So I got my circle back in the form I created it. And there are no changes. It's exactly the same circle which I created. Now again, when I want to create guide of it, I can just select the shape and I can create guide. To release it, I can select guide and release it. Now you would have imagined what will happen if I select the line guide and then click on release. So let's just explore that also. Let us create a horizontal guide. And now we have our guide selected. Go to view guides and release guides. So we got some transformation options here. This is a bounding box. We will see how it works. But right now, if I zoom out, then you can see that it's a line actually. This whole guide got converted into a line. So I can scale it down. I can color it the way I want. And when I press Control 0, so I have created an outline out of it, and again, actually I scaled the guide itself, so like this much, Control 0, and again you can click on it, go to view, guides and make guides. So you have your guide again, and again you can just release it and whatever you want to do. Alright, so that's enough with guides, and that's all we are going to learn with guides and rulers. So I think that's enough information on that topic. Now let's see what all options and what all we can learn in artboards. So to learn artboard, let us quickly make a new file. Go to file, new. Now we have some of artboard options when we create a new file. The other options we can get when while using artboard panel or artboard tool. So let's see what all options do we have when we create a new file. So let's see what all artboard options do we have when we create a new file. So like we saw previously, We have option called number of artboards. So you can increase or decrease using this up arrow and down arrow button over here. So let's say right now I want 3 artboards in my Canva and click on OK. So it created a canvas with 3 artboards. Now I can click with my selection tool selected. I can click on any of the artboard and you can see there's a very very subtle black outline around my active artboard. Like over here, I have selected the second artboard right now. So you can see there's a black border around my artboard right now, which isn't present on these 2 artboards. If it's not visible in the video, you might want to try it on your software and it will be much more visible over there. Alright, so let's again jump back to new file. And now we have few buttons over here which says grid by row, grid by column, arrange by row and arrange by column. Let's see what all these options can do. For this I surely need a lot of more artboards than 4. Let's say we have 13 artboards right now. And we have our first option selected which says grid by row. Now before creating a file, it's a good idea to check this option also, which says number of columns. Now number of columns are 4, so for now just know that we have 4 columns present. How it works, we'll come to that. So click on OK and there we go. We have our 4 columns. So like the icon said, it's arrangement by row. So what it does is create, let me bring up the brush tool here. So how it works is, firstly it creates this artboard, then it goes over here, create this, then it goes over here, create this, and then it goes over here and it creates this. Now we have total number of columns fixed as 4. So what it will do is, it will, every time it will check whether the number of columns are 4 or not. So far the column were 3 and when it created the 4th artboard, the columns are 4. Now it cannot go further and create another artboard over here. So it had to jump back and create a new artboard over here. And again the same way and again go back and again the same way and then again come back to first column. So this is how this arrangement works. Now you could have guessed already that how others will work. So when we click on grid by column, so and click OK, so this is, you have a different arrangement this time. So it is very obvious that it worked in this way. And then for the last artboard it came here, and for future artboards it will go down. Alright, and press Control N. And the same way we have this arrange by row and arrange by column. Now when we click on this, this rows text actually got disabled. Why? Because we will have only one single row this time. And when we click on this, we will have only one single column. So let's see row first and click OK. So here we have all our artboards lined up in a single row. The same way the column works. Let me just close this file, create file new. And this time let's click on 4th icon and click OK. So like this, we have a vertical column this time of all the artboards. It is not a very good idea to have these kind of layout for artboards. I don't know, will I be ever using this kind of layout? But since it's option, it's a good idea to have a knowledge about it. Anyways, so click on new again and this time we will see what this column can do. So we have our artboards total 13 selected and we have our arrangement selected grid by row. Now this time let's say number of columns will be 7. So let's say let's see what all changes it brings. Click on OK and there we go. We have our artboard arrangement in this form now. Again go back here and again start arranging in horizontal direction. Alright, so Now, in second one, you can see when I switch back to second one, which says grid by column, this word changes here from column to row. That means we are limiting number of rows this time. So let's say number of rows are 6. So this is how it works. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It cannot go beyond 6 rows. It can go unlimited number of columns this time, but it cannot go beyond 6 rows. The same was with previous one. It could only create 7 columns, but there was no limit for number of rows. All right, so let's see the last option we have, which is spacing. Now, like the word says, how much space do you want between each artboard? So right now it's 0.5 pixel. You can increase to notice a difference actually. You can increase it to some 3 pixels. That way you can surely notice the difference. Click OK, and yeah, here we have all our artboards lined up with some 3 inch of space between these artboards, both horizontal and vertical. Okay, so that's all the options we have while creating new file. So let us see what all options do we get when we open an artboard panel. So click on File, New. This time I'm just creating two artboards or three artboards. Number of rows 1, or let's say 2 itself. And spacing is 0.5 was better than 3. So 0.5 pixels, sorry, inches, and OK. Now to bring up the artboard panel, you can click on Window, and here you will find artboards. There is no shortcut key for it, so you have to open it from menu bar only. So let's click on artboards, and it opened my artboard panel. So if you have your artboard panel docked already in panel bar, you can just click on this icon, which is like two rectangles, one vertical and one horizontal. Or you can say portrait and landscape mode, and click on this icon so it will open the artboard panel. Now I have few options over here. I can double click on any of this artboard name and rename them. So let's rename this artboard from artboard 1 to let's say design underscore 1, or to name it better, let's say design underscore 1.1. And similarly, I can rename other artboards. I can just click on all of them and double click on the name and say design underscore 1.2, and similarly rename this third artboard to design underscore 1.3. All right, so I have my artboards renamed. Now I can double click on this blank space over here next to the name to focus to that particular artboard, or you can say it works like fit to screen. The way we were using Control 0, it works in the same way. But right now you won't be able to notice much difference which artboard actually is getting highlighted or is getting the main focus, because all of them are having a white background. So let us create some design, or let us create few things over here so that it's more visible. So let's create a star at this artboard, and we will color it yellow or a little of orange, and let us remove the outlines. Sorry, let us remove the outlines from here. Now we can actually have outline of a darker color. I'm taking some time to make it look good. And in the another artboard, let's draw a rounded rectangle. Okay, so color it green this time. It's too bright actually, so let's drop a bit. All right. And here in the third artboard, let's draw a circle. Actually, it's a second artboard, I think. I didn't pay attention at the layout. Yeah, this is second artboard and this is third one. So in the second artboard, we have circle. In the third, we have rounded rectangle. So let us quickly color this one also. Let's color it blue, and it has outline of dark blue. Okay, so we have our three artboards, 1, 2, and 3. I should, instead of creating shapes, I should have named them actually. So let us do that also. Let's say this is artboard 1. Now you might be curious when we are going to learn all this, when we are going to drawing. All we are doing is learning about settings and preferences and all that boring stuff. So we will come to that. It's a good thing to have knowledge about all the settings, because while working, if you stuck at somewhere and you don't know why is it happening, then it gets really frustrated, and that why is it not working, and you lose your quality over the work. And so it's a good idea to know all these things before we start working, so we don't end up in any mess while working, and we can focus on our work rather than just messing up around with the software itself. All right. So we have our artboard 1, artboard 2, artboard 3 ready with their names and shapes. So let us see now, if we go and click on any of this, then we get that artboard on in the focus, or you can see we get that artboard fit to our screen. So that's the way it works then. Now to create a new artboard from this panel itself, we have a new artboard button over here. So what you can do is let's press control negative to zoom out and click on this new artboard. So now it has created a new artboard and it has named it by itself, which is artboard 4, the default name. We can again go and change it to design 1.4 and now why I'm naming it 1.1, 1.2, 1.3? I'm assuming that I'm making some kind of design and I'm having alternate versions of those designs. So let's say in the end, client finalizes the 1.3 version. So I'll just export that artboard only with 1.3 and I'll send it to you. It's kind of like version tracking, just a way to keep our files and work organized, nothing else. Okay, so in this artboard now we can again go and create few things we want and have our artboard ready with a different design. But we are not going to do that, because we have other options to see. So let's say we have any of our artboards selected here and we want to delete it this time. So you have a delete button over here. So it is very obvious that when I press on this when I press this button, so it is very obvious that when I press this button, it will delete the artboard. Okay. Now, if you want to rearrange the artboards, let's say I was getting confused that this is artboard 1, this is artboard 3, and this is 2. So later I come to know that this is actually artboard 2. So if you want to rearrange artboards in this way, you can click on this one. Let's say I want to make this artboard on the third position, or I want to make it artboard 3 rather than 2. So when I select any of the artboard, and you have multiple artboards in your document, if you have a single artboard, you won't be able to use this rearrange buttons over here. So now it says move up. The next button says move down. So let me click on this one. So now this is artboard 3 and this is artboard 2 right now. It's a name, we can see, we can rename them again. We can rename this 1.2, and like you can see, I can have duplicate name of the artboard, so it doesn't make a difference. And we have our artboards renamed and their arrangements changed. So now this is artboard 1, this is artboard 2, this is artboard 3, and this is artboard 4. So let us undo that again. Okay, so we have our three artboards here. Press Ctrl 0 to zoom to fit to zoom in to any one of them. And now let's see what this option can do. We have like a box kind of thing over here next to every artboard. So what this can do, so let's click on this one, and what it does is it gives me a new window or option window which says artboard options. So first of all, let me zoom out and then it will make it more clear. Bring it over here, and now when I click on any of this, let's say I click on second one, so I'm getting certain options only for that artboard. So I can go to preset and I can change its size to anything. I have all the presets present over here. So few of the mobile layouts also. Then I have this VGA layout. Then I have this 1080p and all these things. The print layouts, and I have all these presets present. So I can change it to anyone I want. Let's say I have selected A4 right now. Then if you are looking for a deeper customization, you can go and change these values by yourself and make your own artboard size. Let's say this is some 10 inches and the height will be some 15 inches. So I have customized it the way I want, and now it's so, and now it shows the preset custom over here. Again, this XY position, we can change it, and it will define the X and Y position of the artboard. I just pressed enter actually. So one thing to make sure while doing all this, don't press enter. If you want to see your values reflected, just change the values on any of the text box and press tab instead. So you can see your values reflected. When you press enter, it automatically clicks on OK. So don't do that unless you are sure that your settings are you're sure about your settings actually. So like I was saying, this X will define the X position, that how much should it be in the X and where should it be in the Y. So let's say Y 0, and I press shift tab this time to go to X. Now, so what it does is it brought my artboard center, which is this point, to 0 of Y. So this is the Y axis. Now this is an imaginary line, and this is the X axis. So on the X we have our value to 10 inch, and on the Y we have 0 value. So it is resting over here. So let us say on the Y, if we make it 5 inch. So we have our Y position moved. That means from here it moved 5 inches. It will be a good idea if I bring on rulers, then it will be visible properly and clearly. So let's jump back to artboard options, and yeah, so we have seen width, height, X and Y position. You can explore with these options. Unless you won't explore with these options, you won't be able to grasp them. So make sure you practice all of these things so that it's very clear to you. Now the next option we have is orientation. It is portrait right now. We can switch it to canvas also. We can switch it to landscape also. So if we click on this button, then it got rotated 90 degrees. So right now I'll just keep the portrait, that's fine with me. Now you have this constraint proportions. So when you click on this checkbox, you can see that there is a lock sign which appears on this width and height. When I uncheck it, it disappears. So what it means is now this artboard will scale in proportion. So if I change this value to 5 and press tab, so it is scaling in proportion. Without this, what was happening is, let's change its value again to 10, and this time I'm just turning off the constraint proportions, and now let's change it to 5 and see what happens. So it only scaled width wise. It didn't change the height value at all, but when I turn on the proportions, it maintains the proportion of the artboard. So now if I change it to 10 and press tab, so this is how it works. Alright, so I'm going to press cancel now to reset my settings and go back here again. So we have seen this first, you can say the first group. Now let's see what this display can do. So for that, let me just zoom in a bit to the artboard so it is better visible. This time let's test it on artboard 3. Yeah. Okay. So we have few things over here. We say show center mark. So when I click on this show center mark, you can see there's a crosshair kind of thing at the center of the artboard, which is a center mark. Then you have show crosshairs. Now it brings this crosshair at the edge of the artboards. This brings, the first one brings the crosshair at the center of the artboard. Then you have show video safe areas. So it will show all the safe areas you have, like for the text and for the video and everything. And let us uncheck all of them. So all these options we have in display. Now in the global, it says fade region outside artboard. So let us uncheck this and let's see what happens. So when I uncheck it, so I got this white area all over the place, and I actually don't like it. I like the gray backdrop because it makes a clear difference between artboard and canvas. But anyways, it's a personal choice. You might like white. It's completely up to you. So that's the option we have in the global. And let us press cancel, or you can click OK. Anything is fine. So these are the options we get from artboard panel. Now we have this list kind of icon at the top right corner of the panel. So click on this one, and here we have some more options. The first one is new artboard. The second one is duplicate artboard, delete artboard, delete empty artboards, and artboard option, rearrange artboards. So let's quickly go through all of these options. So for that we need a empty artboard also. So let us click on this button and let's say new artboard first. So we have our new artboard over here, and now let us select artboard 5. Now this time, instead of artboard 4, it named artboard 5 because Illustrator has kept in its memory that I have already created artboard and that I have already created artboard 4, and the new one to be created is artboard 5. It doesn't maintain a history that I actually deleted the fourth one. So that's how this naming works. So don't get confused with the naming. Just rename it if you don't like the names. As simple as that. I'm going to zoom out over here, and what I will do now is duplicate this artboard 5, the newly selected artboard. Sorry, the newly created artboard. So click on this icon and duplicate artboards. So it duplicated the artboard with the name says artboard 5 copy. Just a minute, let me see. Yeah, there is another way to duplicate the artboard also. Let's say if I want to duplicate design 1.1. So you can click on this, drag it, and drop on a new icon. Now let's see where the new artboard has created. So here is the copy of my artboard 1. The good thing is it copied everything along the artboard. I mean the design and everything I have on the artboard, it copied along. So it's a good idea if I want to duplicate a design entirely along with the artboard and I want to make some modifications. So you can do that. Select any of the artboard, or either you can go over here and click on duplicate artboard, or you can just drag it and drop it on new artboard icon. And in the same way, you can rearrange your artboards also. Like previously, we were using up and down arrow keys. These arrows on the artboard. You can just drag and drop to rearrange your artboards over here. So yeah, there are few kind of options for everything. So keep exploring, and you will be familiar with all those options over the time. And you won't be confused anymore. It might happen that right now you are like very, very much confused what is going on. We have so many things to do the same thing. But it's actually freedom, because different artists have different preferences. So I actually prefer this rather than moving it from these buttons. So yeah. Let us quickly go back to a level where we created this. Okay. So we have our two duplicated artboards, two empty artboards, three filled artboards. And now let's select the fifth one and click on delete artboard. So you know what delete artboard will do. It will just delete the artboard, selected artboard. So I'm not clicking on it. Now this option I want to explore, which says delete empty artboards. So let's say we click on this one and see what happens. So yeah, we have our empty artboards deleted. So it's a good option if you have created multiple artboards and you don't know how many designs you are going to create, and in the end you are left with some five or six empty artboards. So you can just click on this and it will delete all your empty artboards. Now we have this convert to artboard. What it will do is, let's say I drew a circle over here on the canvas, and I've selected this shape, and I have drew this circle over the canvas, and I selected this shape. Now if I go and click on convert to artboard, so it says to create artboard, select non-rotated rectangle that are not clipping mask. Now what it means is I can have only a rectangular artboard. Like in the guide, we created a guide out of circle, or we can make a guide out of a star or anything. But when it comes to artboard, you cannot have any shape for artboard. You only need to have a rectangle. That's the only option you get. I just created a rectangle and let's say convert to artboard. So there I have my new artboard. So if you want, let's say along with these artboards, I need a scratch pad or I need something to sketch around my concept. So I just created, you can say, a rough artboard, and then I click on convert to artboard, and there I have my rough artboard. I can just experiment few things over here, and let's say if I want to experiment something, I can just experiment things over here. When things look good, I can just copy them or drag them on these artboards, and yeah, there we go. One thing I want to see, what if the shape is in between over here and I duplicate the artboard? Because previously when we copied the artboard, duplicated the artboard, the shape was inside the artboard. What if it is somewhere like this? Now practically this won't happen, because if you are making your design, it doesn't make any sense to put it outside the artboard, but it's a good for experiment purpose. So let's see what happens. So right now this is the artboard where this star is, and I'm going to duplicate it right now. I'm just clicking and dragging it over the new artboard icon, and there we go. So yeah, it copied the shape, which was halfway through on the artboard, or which was not completely on the artboard. So Let us experiment one more thing. What if I only have a tip of the star on the artboard, and now I'm duplicating it? So there we go. You have your new artboard. Even if there's a single bit of a shape on artboard, it will duplicate your shape along with the artboard. Now we have run into very good thing, very interesting thing. Now we have a shape divided across two artboards. So what if I duplicate it right now? So let us see. Let us see what happens. The shape. Let's put this shape over here. And this shape. Okay. And this shape over here. And now let's duplicate this artboard. This one, the last artboard. So click and drag, and there we go. So it is very confusing right now. So I'm just gonna delete this artboard right now. I didn't delete the actually didn't delete the shapes along with the artboard. There's an option to do that. Right now, just leave it. But anyways, you can see. Even it when I copied the when I duplicated this artboard, this one, the design 1.2 copy 2, it copied all the shapes that were on that artboard. So it copied the left star as well as it copied the right star. So press Control Shift Control Z, and you can see over here that it copied all the shapes which are on this artboard. Even if there is a shape which is like spreading across two artboard, so it depends which artboard you copy, and the shape will get copied along with that artboard. Alright, so enough with experiment. Let's just delete these three artboards. Let's delete all the shapes, and where were we? Yeah, we were seeing how to create our own custom artboards. So let us delete all the shapes, and let's say delete empty artboards over here, and then we can again from here also we can go to artboard option and change everything over here. Click on OK or cancel and click on delete, whatever you want to do, it's up to you. So I'm going to click cancel right now, and let's see the last option we have, which says rearrange artboard. So let us click on this and see what's with this option. So I got a new window which says rearrange artboards, and we have few of our familiar icons which we saw during new file, and we have this column space over here and the spacing and move artwork with artboard. Now you would have already guessed what all it will do, and actually by this time you know that what all options this will do. So I'm just skipping it right now. I don't want to cover it in this because we have already covered it. The only thing I'm covering is this thing, which is change to right to left layout. When I click on this, you can see all these icons got flipped. So it's the same way now. Previously, artboards were arranging in this format, so this and this, and then it again come back to first column and this and this. So it was going from left to right. So when you click on that icon, it switches the direction, so it goes from right to left. So it's as simple as that. So we need not to create a separate example for that one. We'll quickly go over here, rearrange artboards, and we'll see the last one, which says move artwork with artboard. Now, like we saw earlier when we were duplicating stuff and we were moving artboard, so it was moving this star and circle along with it because this option was checked in. If we unselect it and then click OK, and then we rearrange these artboards, and let's say I want this into entire row and click OK, so I have my shape messed up all over the place. Certainly, it arranged all the artboards in a row, but I have my artwork spread all across the artboards, and this is not something I want to do. So I just undoed it and rearrange, and this time I checked on this icon, sorry checkbox and clicked on OK with this arrangement on a single row. So yeah, this time I have my artwork copied along with the artboard, and this looks neat. So I will go ahead with this one. So all right, so that's all we can cover in artboard panel. Now the next thing we will come to is artboard tool. But I am thinking right now that we are actually running out of time, and again we might have to cover it in tomorrow's lecture. So tomorrow we are going to cover is artboard tool, and we will see what all export options we have if we want to export all our artboards into images. We can either skip it right now, the exporting part, because we will anyways cover it when we create our files and when we create our design. So we are going to deal with export options. So tomorrow we will start with the artboard tool, and then we will see some of the drawing tools like rectangle and oval tools and all. So that's it for today. I will see you in my next video. Goodbye.